Christmas blessings to you all. Welcome to Christmas Eve worship here at First Presbyterian Church. I know we all wish that we were packed into the pews, sitting shoulder to shoulder, preparing to sing Silent Night together. But today we celebrate Christmas in a different way, trusting always that God is bigger than even all of the changes or the cancellations that have come to some of our favorite traditions. We believe that Christ's light still shines bright on this night. So as we worship and as we will light our candles later in the service, we think about how Christmas Eve always calls us to carry Christ's light with us out into the world. And today, as we worship, we're doing just that. So on this day, may Christ's light shine bright in your homes and across our world. Together, on this Christmas Eve, let us worship God.
Please join me in the call to worship. On this day, we light our final Advent candle. On this day, we celebrate Christ's light arriving into our world. We celebrate Christ's humble and vulnerable entry into the world as a baby. We celebrate Mary, who said yes to bearing God into the world. We celebrate Joseph, who went against the grain to serve God. We celebrate shepherds who share the good news of Christ's birth. Let us give thanks this day for the newborn King. Let us pray. Great God, as you came at night when all was still, so enter our lives this night. Illumine our paths with the light of Christ's presence, and go with us as we do our best to carry the light into the world. On this Christmas Eve, may we feel the wonder and awe of the shepherds, and may we offer our gifts in worship like the Magi. Oh, come, let us adore him. In and through Christ we pray. Amen.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Great God, as you came at night when all was still, so enter our lives this night. Illumine our paths with the light of Christ's presence, and go with us as we do our best to carry that light into the world. On this Christmas Eve, may we feel the wonder and the awe of the shepherds. May we offer our gifts in worship like the Magi. O come, let us adore him. In and through Christ we pray. Amen.
A reading from Luke chapter 1, verses 26 through 35, and then 46 through 48. Listen to and for God's word to you. In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin engaged to a man whose name was Joseph, of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary. And he came to her and said, "Greetings, favored one, the Lord is with you." But she was much perplexed by his words and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. The angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary. You have found favor with God. And now you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great, and he will be called the Son of the Most High, and the Lord God will give to him the throne of his ancestor David. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I'm a virgin?" The angel said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be holy. He will be called the Son of God. And now your relative Elizabeth, in her old age, has also conceived a son. And this is the sixth month for her who was said to be barren. For nothing will be impossible with God." Then Mary said, "Here am I, the servant of the Lord. Let it be with me according to your word." Then the angel departed from her. And Mary said, "My soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God my Savior. For he has looked with favor on the lowliness of his servant. Surely, from now on, all generations will call me blessed."
Good night, Laura. Good night, Catherine.
Night, Laura. Night, Catherine. Have a good sleep.
Wait a minute. Can't you guys stay a little while longer?
What's going on, girls? You need to get some sleep.
Well, I'm scared. That book just made me think of all the things I'm afraid of. Me too.
Like what?
Well, there's bees, Voldemort, frostbite, COVID-19, there's Home Alone, and Harry Potter and the Order of the Phoenix, there's spiders, yeah.
And thunderstorms.
Whoa! Sounded like you guys just listed everything you're afraid of. I can relate. Sometimes I feel scared too.
Well, how can I feel better? Right now I'm really scared. I can't sleep when I'm scared.
Aw, well, stories help.
When I'm scared or worrying, I like to remind myself that I'm part of a story that's way bigger than I am. We're all part of God's story. You know, I think we might have time for one more story tonight. This story comes from a time when many people were afraid of many things, just like we are right now. It all begins in Nazareth, in a town called Galilee, with a woman named Mary.
Hi. Welcome. Welcome to my home. Do you want to talk to me? We haven't met before, have we? Is there something you'd like to hear from me?
Pardon? Yes, let me start over. Greetings, favored one. God is with you.
What kind of a greeting is that?
Do not be afraid, Mary, for you shall have a son, and you shall name him Jesus. He shall be the Son of God, and his kingdom shall have no end.
Well, how can this be? How is this going to happen?
The shadow of the Holy Spirit will come upon you, and therefore the baby shall be born holy. Also, your relative Elizabeth, you know how she thought she couldn't have children? She's going to have a child.
Was all of that a question?
Maybe.
Are you asking me if I want to do this?
Yes.
Here I am, the servant of the Lord. Let it be according to this message. I need to see Elizabeth.
Are you home, Elizabeth? I'm coming in.
Oh, come on in, Mary. Mary, I have something to tell you. Mary, you are amongst blessed of women, and the baby in your womb is also blessed. Feel the baby in my womb. It leaped for joy when it heard your voice.
I too am bursting with good news. God took one look at me, and look at me now. I'm the most blessed woman in the earth. What God has done will not be forgotten. I'm talking about the God who brought down the powerful and brought up the lowly. So, can I stay with you for a few months?
Mary is pregnant. How can this be? We're not even married yet. The law says that this is not good. It's not good at all. She claims that this child, the child that she carries, is God's child. The only option I have is to marry her and then divorce her quietly. That would save my reputation, at least. But she would be disgraced. I don't know what to do. And I'm so afraid. Oh, Mary.
Joseph, son of David. Do not be afraid to get married. God's Holy Spirit has made Mary pregnant. She will have a son, and you will name him Jesus. God saves, because he will save his people from their sins.
I'm gonna marry Mary. I'm gonna marry Mary. And we are gonna have a child and name him Jesus. I'm gonna be a dad. I need a pack.
Why was Joseph afraid of Mary having a baby?
Do angels still visit people in dreams?
Why is everybody making such a big deal of it, about this? It's just a baby. This story is so weird.
Yeah, so I don't have the answer to all of those questions. This is a bigger-than-life type of story. It has lots of unexplainable and miraculous events.
That sounds like Pastor Didi. When I ask tough questions.
Well, good. I'm glad I sound like Pastor Didi, because we don't have all the answers. But I do have the answers to one of those questions. Why was Joseph packing a bag? To understand that, we need to meet the Emperor.
Citizens of Rome, it is I, your Lord and Savior, your Good Shepherd, the Light, the Way, the Prince of Peace, Caesar Augustus. First, I want to say to you all, you're welcome for all of the great things that I have done for you. There has never been an emperor as powerful and as glorious as me. My empire is vast, you people are obedient, and I am saving all of you. All of you. And you owe me so much. So much. So, my citizens, I want to count you. Yes, let's get a good head count so that you can all pay me what I am owed. Each of you go to your hometown and register your family so that you can show proper appreciation of my awesomeness. I decree it to be so. And so farewell, my faithful children. May you always know my magnificent ways. Farewell.
Okay, good news. I found us a place to stay.
That's great. Is it the inn that I like? The one with the good breakfast?
Not exactly. That place was full.
Full? Well, what are we gonna do? Are we gonna stay outside with the shepherds or in the stables with all the donkeys?
The donkeys? Who would do something like that?
Well, what are we gonna do? What place did you find?
Well, there's a nice innkeeper who's gonna lend us a place in his room.
Okay, is it nice?
Yeah, it's nice. It's got a lot of hay and maybe some animals.
Oh. Okay, let's do this.
The Bible doesn't really teach us much about the birth anyway. All it says is that Mary had the baby, wrapped him in strips of cloth, and placed him in a feeding trough. But remember those details of the story for later on.
Okay, keep going.
Okay.
Yeah, keep going.
I will. There were shepherds outside, working in a field. They were about to be frightened by some of God's messengers. But soon they realized they didn't have any reason to be afraid.
Glory to God in the highest!
Glory to God!
Is this thing even working right here? Can you guys even hear me? Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all the people.
Today in the town of David, a Savior is born to you.
He's the Messiah, the Lord.
This will be a sign to you.
You will find a baby, wrapped in cloths,
and lying in a manger.
Good news for all the people.
The Messiah is born, a Savior. Glory to the highest heavens.
And on earth, peace for all those who God favors.
That is all. Goodbye.
So, you guys both saw that, right?
Yes. Yes, we did.
Bah. Yep, that happened.
Bah.
Well, we are going, right?
Yes, we're going. We have to go.
Do we take the sheep?
I think we have to.
Bah, bah. Yeah, we want to come.
Take us with you. Bah, bah.
And what were those signs again?
A baby.
Wrapped in strips of cloth.
Lying in a manger.
Bah, bah.
We won't forget. Let's go.
You too, sheep. Come on.
That was a miracle.
Bah.
It was exactly how the angel had described.
The baby was wrapped in a cloth and lying in a manger. Friends, we have seen something amazing tonight. I don't know about you, but I feel like the world is changing.
Yeah, but why do you think we got to see it? Nobody cares about us shepherds. We're poor and we don't have much power.
I have no idea, but the baby's mother, Mary, acted like this was exactly what was supposed to happen. Like this was meant for people like us. Maybe the baby will lift us up the lowly.
And bring down the lofty. Wouldn't that be something?
It sure would. I believe there is no limit to what this baby can do.
Hey, shepherds, was that star there last night? I don't think I've ever seen one like that before.
So brave and determined.
Yeah, I think everybody in the story was.
Mm-hmm.
From Mary to Joseph to the shepherds to the Magi. They all knew Jesus' birth would change the world.
Mm-hmm. Laura and Catherine, are you feeling safe and sleepy now?
Yeah, I'm feeling really safe and sleepy. Oh, but this is not really the end.
No, why not? It's bedtime. You have to get some sleep.
Well, this is just the beginning. Jesus is born, he grows up, he flips tables, he teaches, he heals, he changes the world, he turns wine into water, he...
Yes, yes, you're right. Jesus' birth is just the beginning. But it's getting late, so tonight let's focus on this one special moment, this one night that brought us Jesus.
Okay, that makes sense. That was a good story.
Yeah. The God story is unfolding each and every day. There's more and more wonderful things that are taking place. And in the end, all will be set right. We might be scared a little bit along the way, and that's all right. But in the end, we trust that love and justice will have the final word.
Thank you.
to take a moment and to light a candle in your home. Take a moment to imagine passing the light to your friend or your neighbor or your loved one. Tonight, we take a moment to receive Christ's light that's come into our world, to receive it into our hearts. And as we remember that this work of cherishing Christ's light, holding Christ's light, and moving it out into the world, we remember that that now all falls to us. So let us sing together on this night, Silent Night. And on the final verse, make sure to hold your candle high. Before you extinguish your candle, just take a moment to pause, to breathe deep, to give thanks to God for this child that has come to bring peace. This night, may each and every one of us, wherever we are, feel an extra measure of Christ's peace. Friends, go out into the world in peace. Have courage. Hold on to what is good. Return no person evil for evil. Strengthen the faint-hearted, support the weak, help the suffering. Honor all people. Love and serve the Lord, rejoicing always in the power of the Holy Spirit. And through it all, may you be surrounded by the love of God, who is always our Creator, our Redeemer, our Sustainer, and our Friend. Amen.